ask me who will be the next heavyweight champion after me. And I tell them, I intend to hold the championship for 8 years. Then I'm going to give it to my younger brother, Rudolph, like the Kennedys do in Washington. When I retire, I will become an even bigger businessman than I am now. I'm already a big businessman, but I'm going to be the AT&T of the fistic world. I have a unique product. I sell good boxing, a beautiful body, culture, and the world's most perfect face. I'm so beautiful, the girls think I'm Chubby Chap. I am the greatest. I'm too much. When I retire from the ring, I'm going into business by making boxers out of other handsome, talented, cultured young men. If a kid can box, and if he can write poetry, and if he's anywhere near as pretty as me, I'll sign him to a contract. I will have a stable of fighters, a coast-to-coast chain of Cassius Clays. The flyweight Cassius Clay will weigh 112 pounds, and he will write short little poems. The heavyweight Cassius Clay will write long elegies. They all will predict things. They will predict that I will be the first man elected to the Hall of Fame while I'm still alive. And they won't have to put up a statue of me because I will appear at the Hall of Fame in person, live from New York in living color. Yes, I will revolutionize the boxing world. And then I will revolutionize the literary world. First, I will get rid of the beatnik poets. And I will make the world safe for cleanliness. We don't need beatniks. Their poems don't rhyme. Their clothes don't match. And they can't fight a lick. I saw some of those beatniks doing my poetry reading in Greenwich Village. One beatnik had bare feet, dirty fingernails, and a long beard. You know, if that beatnik had put on shoes, gotten a manicure, and a shave, she'd been beautiful. And she had the nerve to challenge me to a poetry duel. I predicted that I would beat that beatnik with one quick poem to the brain. And I did. I said, "Little Miss Beatnik, go sit on your seat." Now I beat her with that short little old poem. And I can write even shorter poems. While I'm talking to you, I'm writing the greatest short poem of all time. This poem tells how it feels to be as great as I am. This is it. The greatest short poem of all time. Me, wee!
Congratulations, Mr. Clay. That was a truly magnificent performance.
Oh, it was nothing. though they did seem to like my dithyrams.
Were you in trouble at any time?
Yes, I was having a bit of trouble with my iambic pentameter in the first few poems, but it cleared up, and from then on it was easy going.
Did you ever have the feeling that you weren't going to make it all the way?
Au contraire. They were a tough audience, but I would gladly give them a return concert anytime they're ready.
Cassius, you don't even seem winded.
No, but I am a little dry.
Oh, would you like a cup of coffee?
Coffee? No. Wait, I'd sooner listen.
Mr. Clay, do you have anything more you want to say to the American people?
Yes, I want the American people to know that I am the greatest.
They know it.
Oh, that reminds me. Using that Greek chorus in the background was a brilliant idea. They were wonderful.
Thank you.
They learned a great deal from me. I taught them everything I know.
We are the greatest.
I see what you mean. Mr. Clay, do you have any more predictions to make?
Yes, I will make the greatest prediction I've ever made. I have predicted when fights will end. I have predicted when poems will end. I have even predicted when Sun and Listen will end. Now I will predict the exact number of copies this album will sell. I predict this will be the best-selling album of all time. It will outsell My Fair Lady and the First Family album combined. This record will go 8 zillion.
But Mr. Clay, no record has ever sold 8 zillion.
That's because I've never recorded before, and I am the greatest.
Should tremble and fall, or the mountain.
join in the fun. Hey, hey, the gang's all here. We're gonna swing as one.
One more time.
Hey, hey, the gang's all here. Join in the fun. Hey, hey, the gang's all here. We're gonna swing as one.
It's New York with me. It's Chicago with me. It's Los Angeles with me. Am I the greatest?
Hey, hey, the gang's all here. Join in the fun. Hey, hey, the gang's all here. We're gonna swing as one.
It's London with me. It's Paris with me. Is Rome with me?
Yeah.
Am I the greatest?
Yeah.
Hey, hey, the gang's all here. Join in the fun. Hey, hey, the gang's all here. We're gonna swing as one.
You pretty, you shook up the world, do something else, tell it. It's Memphis with me.
Yeah.
It's Louisville with me.
Yeah.
It's Houston with me.
Yeah.
Am I the greatest?
Yeah.
Hey, hey, the gang's all here. Join in the fun.
Ain't we pretty?
Hey, hey, the gang's all here. We gonna swing as one. Hey, hey, the gang's all here. Join in the fun. Hey, hey, the gang's all here. We gonna swing as one.
I have had 20 professional fights, won them all, of course. And in 13 of those bouts, I predicted the exact round in which my opponent would hit the ground. Now, that's really something. Even I am impressed by that. Since I predict the exact round in which a fight will end, people are always asking me to predict other things in the future. And I tell them the future will be wonderful. In the future, science will get rid of the common cold. The government will get rid of unemployment, and I'm gonna get rid of Sonny Liston. Folks, the future will be great, because that's where I will spend the rest of my life. Any place I am has got to be the greatest. And to give you a better idea of what the future will be like, here's a scene from my great play about the future entitled, Stop the Fight, Liston Wants to Get Off.
National holiday, son. Today is Cassius Clay's birthday.
Ah, Cassius Clay? Is he the man who chopped down a cherry tree?
Oh, why no, son. He's the man who chopped down Sonny Liston.
Ah! Mommy, how long ago did he do that?
Over 150 years ago.
Yeah! Gosh, he must have been a great man.
What do you mean, must have been? He still lives. He's 175 years old today, the oldest living ex-president.
And outside, there's going to be a parade in his honor.
A parade? What's in the parade?
Just catch it, son. Why don't you go outside and see it?
Hey! He didn't brush his teeth.
I know, but you can't expect him to brush after every meal.
Cassius Clay does.
Cassius is being interviewed on television. I think I'll turn on the wall.
Tell the audience, Mr. Clay, how does it feel to be 175 years old today?
This is my happiest birthday. The day of my greatest joy. For this morning, my wife presented me with a bouncing baby boy. Him after me, just like the other 93.
Sir, looking back, what is the greatest honor you've ever received?
I've been honored everywhere. I'm the world's greatest honor receiver. I'm the only man with honorary degrees from Southern Methodist, Notre Dame, and Yeshiva.
You must be very grateful.
Yes, I am gratefulest. And because this nation had been so kind to the lip from Louisville, I didn't forget my country when I made out my will. To this nation, I've made this bequest. So spread the word north and south. Some folks leave their brains to science, but when I go, I'm leaving my mouth. It's the greatest.
Me, a little old kid who don't even shave yet. I'm going to be champ of the world before I'm old enough to do my first shaving commercial. And I'm going to make boxing popular again. Me with my beautiful, colorful personality. I'm going to make boxing interesting. Boxing doesn't have to be dull. It's the fighters who are dull. I watched the fight of the week on TV. They call that the fight of the week? It was so boring, every time the bell rang, it woke up the referee. It hurts me to say this because I know a lot of fighters, and I like them. They are nice, gentle guys who wouldn't hurt anybody, not even in the ring. And I'm going to bring back the excitement in boxing. I'm going to be the heavyweight champion of the world, and I won't be satisfied with that. After becoming champion of the world, I'm going to become champion of the universe. I want to take on those little green men from Venus. Those slick, shiny-headed green men. I can lick them. I won't be afraid of the way they look. After all, they can't look no worse than Sonny Liston. Yes, America, I'm the resurrector of the fight game. I'm going to save boxing. I'm going to bring boxing back to life. Fighting was dull until I came along because the greatest wasn't around. But time brings about a change. As the earth rotates around the sun, a change takes place. There's spring, summer, fall, and winter. Boxing was at the winter stage. But now the flowers are blooming. Spring is coming. I am on the horizon. Liston's fall will mark the arrival of spring. Yes, there's gonna be a new champion. A champion you can tell your kids to be like. I'm a perfect idol for the kids. I'm good looking, clean living, culture, and I am modest. I am so modest I can admit my own fault. My only fault is I don't realize how great I really am. It's hard to be humble when you are as great as I am. I'm the new frontier of boxing, and boxing must move ahead. I'm going to win the championship with vigor. That's part of my physical fitness program. All Sonny Liston's got is a physical fatness program. And with my vigor, I'm going to ask Congress to help Mr. Liston. I will ask Yes, I'm going to move boxing ahead. I don't ask what boxing can do for me, I ask what I can do for boxing. Because I am great, I am the greatest. And I can even tell the truth about the future. To prove this point, I would like to read one of the many masterpieces I wrote this afternoon. My prophecies by Cassius Clay. When Cassius says a fight will go five rounds, the bell for the six just never sound. When I tangled with Archie, I predicted four, and that's all there was, there wasn't any more. When they queried me about the coup about, I answered with Shakespearean thrift. When they asked me what round I knocked Henry out, I answered, Henry the Fifth. People ask me how I became a poet. I tell them, I didn't become a poet. I was born the poet. Poetry comes natural to me, like boxing. A lot of people are surprised that a fighter like me is such a great poet. They say boxing and poetry don't mix. They are wrong. Boxing and poetry do mix. This same fist that can knock out a man holds a pen that writes a poem. Now that's poetic justice. Poetry and boxing do mix. All the great poets should have been fighters. Take Keats and Shelley for an example. They were pretty good poets, but they died young. You know why? Because they didn't train. They say you should write poems about what you know, about what you love. I write poems about what I love. I write about me. A lot of people don't see the beauty in poetry. They don't realize that a poem is even more beautiful than a left jab to the nose. To show you the beauty in poetry, I like to read a poem by one of the greatest poets of all time. This is the most beautiful poem ever written. I wrote it about 6 months ago. This is my greatest poem, and I'm looking forward to 1965 when I'm going to read it in Washington, D.C. at the inauguration of the president. This poem is entitled, I Am the Greatest, number 73, by Cassius Clay. For those of you who haven't heard, I'm a most enchanting guy.
A most enchanting guy.
The greatest boxer that ever lived. Would you like me to tell you why?
Tell us why. Tell us why.
I was born the champion. I'm poetic. I'm brash. I swing.
Swing.
My greatness is too much for me. Man, I'm everything.
Thing.
Cassius of old dropped Caesar 20 centuries ago.
Go, go, go.
And this Cassius will cool listening, as you already know.
No, no, no.
Yes, yes, yes. For at the end of the bout, you are gonna hear the ref shout.
The winner and new champion.
Mr. Liston won't see that the victor is me. For stars are all he'll be seen.
Twinkle, twinkle, little stars. Liston's on his way to Mars.
No, Liston won't hear. He'll be flat on his ear. And I'll be new champion.
No, you'll be new champion.
They all must fall in the round I call.
They all must lose in the round you choose.
You can say that again.
They all must lose in the round you choose.
I am the greatest.
Hail Cassius, you are the greatest.
And just as I prophesy the round of each victory, I hereby claim I can do the same with this bit of poetry.
Impossible.
We don't believe it.
I can achieve it.
We'll bet you can't do it.
Don't wager, you'll ruin it.
We think it's a fiction. What's your prediction?
Just to save time, three words from me will end this rhyme.
It's one of his jokes.
That's all, folks.
Been asked, what will I do after I retire from the ring?
Since I'm so dramatic and so theatrical, I will write for the theater. I will become Kentucky Clay. Now I would like to present a scene from one of my short poetic dramas. This play is very symbolic. The character named Cassius symbolizes me and represents greatness and beauty. The play is set in very old England. It is called Much Ado About Cassius, or The Lady Is Not for Bernie.
Dragon hath dragooned again. Last night he vanquished our last knight.
Alas, with no more knights left, is there no one who can stop the fire-breathing dragon?
Oh, King Daddy, there is one in the court who speaketh much of his desire to slay the dragon. He is but a youth, but he has already put down 6 dragons.
Oh, what a put down!
Tell me, daughter, this youth, how is he called?
The one does but shout his name, and there he is.
I know the youth, fire. The dragons he hath defeated are but the small dragons from across the sea. Do you know the small dragons I speak of?
Yes, they are the Volks dragons. But seriously, though, folks, I wouldst have words with this youth. Page him.
Send forth for Cassius of Clay.
Send forth for Cassius of Clay.
Send forth for Cassius of Clay.
Dire, this is the youth.
And so, thou art the stripling that wouldest kill the dragon?
Not wouldest, but couldest.
Goodest.
Give me but leave to slay, and he'll breathe no fire at the end of day.
Young sir, to arrive at the dragon, one must cross the dangerous and treacherous moor. You willest need 7 league boots.
I worry not the danger. I have archly crossed the moor. I had no need for 7 league boots. I only needed 4.
He thinks this lad has a tongue in his mouth. With that tongue of sword, the dragon wouldst be holier than thou. What thinkest thou, daughter?
Oh, your fathership, I loveth him. And when I think that he may fail to deliver us from the dragon, I quiver.
Fair maid, do not quiver. I deliver. And I will return with yon dragon's pate when your sundial strikes the hour of 8.
And Cassius went forth across the moor.
Oh, oh.
And Cassius went 5th past the home of Henry the cooper.
Oh, no.
Oh, yes. And as he walked upon the road, his thoughts were on the wench. And he did not spy the dragon belching fire and creating a scene.
Meanwhile, back at the wench.
Oh, King Daddy, King Daddy, disaster hath struck us.
What is the matter with?
Clouds have obscured the sun. My sundial stoppeth. Who knows the hour? Who?
The little hen is on the 8th.
And the big hand is on the 12th.
Thank you.
You're
welcome.
Oh, alas, alack, I fear brave Cassius will not come back.
Have no fear, daughter, for on the horizon I see the lad coming, and he's pulling a dragon.
Hooray, 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 hooray. After all his bragging, he's dragging a dragon.
He carries a pate that is no longer burning.
He has slain it, the dragon. I will call it a day and make him a knight. I dub thee Sir Cassius, and as further reward, I give thee my daughter's hand.
Yoinks! acclaim it is the best of her. I must refuse. Please understand, unless you throw in the rest of her.
The young knight is wise to speak thusly.
And practical.
And he is so handsome. Our mother told me there'd be knights like this.
Sire, my thanks I give really, but may I speak freely?
At some other time, as for now, continue in rhyme.
I have slain the dragon, and that's that, sir. But the reward I've received seems quite flat, sir.
I resent that.
It's not that I don't like your daughter, but I was hoping you'd give me your hat, sir.
My crown? It weighs too much for thy young brow.
Sire, don't think me a clown, but it's just what I want, a heavyweight crown.
If that's what you wish it, it's yours.
Will Cassius
put on the heavyweight crown?
Will Cassius
wed the king's daughter?
Will Cassius
be given a title?
Will Cassius
be given a purse?
Will Cassius
enjoy the scene?
Will Cassius
enjoy the success?
Don't tune in tomorrow. The answer is
yes. And I'm going to greater glory yet. I'm going to be my own port laureate. Countrymen, lend me your ears. I come to Barry Liston, not to praise him. I'm going to fight Sonny Liston. That is, if he doesn't chicken out. I will win that fight because I'm president of the boxing world. And this fist is my veto. I am the greatest. Mr. Liston is an old man. He's 30 years old. No business been in the same ring with me. I'd like to help that poor man. I want to give him lessons. Boxing lessons. Talking lessons. I'll teach him anything. But since he's gonna fight me, what he needs most is falling lessons. He can't fight. I watched him shadow boxing. And his shadow won in the first round. And then he has the nerve to say to the newspapers that I need respect knocked into me when it was him who was disrespectful to me. He says I'm cocky when it was he who has the nerve to think he belong in the same ring with me. He should be ashamed of himself. I can picture my fight with old man Lister. I will step into the ring looking like a beautiful movie star. And for the first six rounds, I'll go pop, 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 and dance away so fast, Lister will think he's surrounded. And then I'm really gonna start swinging, and I'm gonna get angry, and I hear a voice saying,
control yourself. Sure, you've got a headache. You're tired and irritable. But that's no reason to take it out on poor old Sonny.
After I finish with old Mr. Liston, the president is gonna send out a proclamation, and Liston's jaw will be declared a disaster area. My only regret is I won't be able to be at ringside giving a blow-by-blow description of the eighth round. That's the last round. I would report that round in poetry. As As a matter of fact, I have already written a poem that describes it. Here is the eighth round of the Clay Liston fight, exactly as it will happen. Clay comes out to meet Liston, and Liston starts to retreat. But if he goes back an inch farther, he'll end up in a ringside seat. Clay swings with his left, Clay swings with his right. Look at young Cassius carry the fight. Liston keeps backing, but there's not enough room. It's a matter of time, and Clay lost the boom. Now Clay lands a right, what a beautiful swing. The punch raises Liston clear out of the ring. Liston's still rising, and the ref wears a frown, for he can't start counting till Sonny comes down. Now Liston disappears from view. The crowd is getting frantic, but our radar stations have picked him up. He's somewhere over the Atlantic. Who would have thought when they came to the fight that they witnessed the launching of a human satellite? Yes, the crowd did not dream when they put down their money that they would see a total eclipse of the sun. I have graciously consented to ask any questions you and the audience might have.
Do you have anything personal against Sonny Liston?
No, he's a nice old man, but he's got my job. Oh, I don't resent it. After all, it was that chap who ran out of petrol.
Mr. Clay, do you really believe you're handsome?
Of course I'm handsome. My face should be considered a natural resource. And the Secretary of Interior should appropriate money to preserve my beauty. To preserve Mr. Liston's face, money should be appropriated by the Bureau of Wildlife.
Television show.
Yes, I have already been offered my own show. It will be called The Great Great Show. Not only will I star on the show, but every week I will be my own guest star.
What do you dislike most?
People who are stuck on themselves.
Mr. Clay, have you ever been in love?
Not with anyone else. I would like to ask you a few questions. Who's the greatest?
Cassius Clay!
Who's the most dutiful and the most beautiful?
Cassius Clay!
You all know it. Who's the greatest poet?
Cassius Clay!
Let's hear it confess. Who's the most handsomest?
Cassius Clay!
Telling me no lies, who's got the most beautiful eyes?
Cassius Clay!
Who's got the greatest style? Who's got the biggest smile?
Cassius Clay!
Like a piston.
Cassius Clay.
I'm hip. Who's the gassiest and the brassiest?
Cassius Clay.
Here's one more for the list. Who's the greatest pugilist?
Cassius Clay.
Don't ring that bell. I haven't finished. Unring that bell. Okay, that's better. You all know the latest. Who's the greatest?
Cassius Clay.
Let's hear it again. Who's the greatest of men?
Cassius Clay!
One more time, who's the most sublime?
Cassius Clay!
Okay, I'm finished.
And now, ladies and gentlemen, from Louisville, Kentucky, wearing black tie, Mr. Cassius Marcellus Clay. For his first reading, Mr. Clay will honor us with a recitation of his classic poem, I Am the Greatest.
Oh,
Cassius Clay, the most beautiful fighter in the world today. He talks a great deal and brags indeedy of a muscular punch that's incredibly speedy. The fistic world was dull and weary. With a champ like Liston, things had to be dreary. Then someone with color, someone with dash, brought fight fans a-running with cash. This brash young boxer is something to see, and the heavyweight championship is his destiny. This kid fights great, he's got speed and endurance, but if you sign to fight him, increase your insurance. This kid's got a left, this kid's got a right. If he hits you once, you're asleep for the night. And as you lie on the floor, while the ref counts 10, you pray that you won't have to fight me again. For I am the man this poem is about, the next champ of the world, there isn't a doubt. This I predict, and I know the score. I'll be champ of the world in 64. When I say three, they go into third. So don't bet against me, I'm a man of my word. If Cassius says a cow can lay an egg, don't ask how, grease that skillet. He is the greatest. Yes, I'm the man this poem is about. I'll be champ of the world, there isn't a doubt. Here I predict Mr. Liston's dismemberment. I'll hit him so hard, he'll wonder where October and November went. When I say two, that's never a third. Betting against me is completely absurd. When Cassius says a mouse can outrun a horse, don't ask how, put your money where your mouse is.